We now look at representing vectors by their magnitude and direction. In this example, we have a force here. We can represent this force by its magnitude, which is the length of the vector, and the angle from the x-axis going towards the y-axis. We can also separately represent the velocity as a vector with its own magnitude and direction. Notice that in this example, the velocity is in a different direction than the force.